I usually age them about a week, depending on the size. If they're big, I might give them a bit longer. But for a little fallow like this, a week is plenty, otherwise it starts drying out too much. Also depends on your setup. Right, first step is get this off. The reason I leave the furs on, because that's dried out, but that hasn't. So I always just try and do a bit of a trim. All this stuff just goes to the dogs. Just make it a little bit easier when you've got cuts. There's a couple ways you do this, but for a small fallow, usually just run the seam at the silver side. And that will come off with the hamstring, like that. And you can just pull the hamstring off separate. Silver side. Sometimes you can just cut the rump off normal, but I do it there. Then run the bone for the round. Over the kneecap. So pull all that meat off. And that's your top side. See all those dried out junky bits? That could go to the dogs. Shank. I usually take the bone off just because it fits a bit easier in the freezer. But if you want to leave the bone on, it doesn't matter. Dog bones, shanks, I just put in the slow cooks, your rounds. Now you do get little extra bits on that. That's going to go into my mince. Trim off all this stuff, all the fascia and tissue. You don't want any of that. And if you want, you can do just little steaks, like so. With bigger animals, you get bigger steaks, but obviously. Or if you want. So, I'll do those ones up, but another round. Ones that are a bit bigger, might put into a roast. Be topside. With all of them, you want to get all that white stuff off. It's white, it's no good, basically. All that good stuff will go to the mince, but again, same with the top side. Just make them into nice steaks. They're not very big off the fallow, but same idea. And the silver side, same thing. Get that gunk off. The main one you want to get off, you want to get rid of that. So, just like if you're skinning a fish, run that off. You don't really want that in your mince, it's just a big tendon basically. And you get your nice chunks. All these extra bits, you can just throw them in with your mince, so you get nice pieces. And then same thing, because that one's a bit small, I might do a bit of a long steak instead. So yeah, silver side, round, top side, shank. And the rump, I usually just throw that. If it's big enough, I'll throw it in like a stir fry or something, but if it's small, I'll just throw it in the mince. Just depends on what size animal it is. But that one, there's not much to it, it can just be minced up. Done.